Hey, this is Mariela from The Functional Company. Let's talk about protein. So I'm gonna give you an overview about protein, and there's definitely lots more to know regarding protein. It's a very interesting topic, but I just wanna give you something with which to think when you're looking at protein. So if we look at the macronutrients, we're looking at carbohydrates. Macro means large, so carbohydrates, proteins, and fat. Carbohydrates and fat are a source of fuel for the cell, so the cell will take that and produce energy with either fat or carbohydrates, and you get to pick one with which the cell will rely on. Protein, on the other hand, it's the raw material that the body needs in order to rebuild itself. So you can actually look at a body and see whether or not it's deficient in some kind of protein source, because you'll see that the nails will be brittle, the skin might be aged more quickly, the hair might be brittle, the joints might be stiff. There's just some lack of protein that the body might have. And so our bodies require some amount of protein. Depending on your goals and depending on your own physique, you might need more or less protein, but what's true is that you need some amount of protein. So there are different kinds of sources of protein, and so like a protein is made up of something called amino acids. So each type of protein, and when I say protein, I'm just to give you some examples of proteins, you get some kinds of proteins from plants, you get some from animals, you get different types from organ meats than you do from like chicken breast, for example. The skin also has a different profile of a protein than, like milk or chicken breast, etc. So bones have a different protein source. And so it's good to kind of get a variety of different proteins. And like I said, the building blocks of these are amino acids. So, you know, when you look at just, if you looked up all the amino acids, you're gonna see some that actually say essential amino acids. The word essential in nutrition basically means that it's essential that you consume it from the diet. It means that your body does not produce it. You have to get it from the diet. That's something important to keep in mind, because when you're looking at, you know, what proteins do I need, you also wanna make sure that you're getting these essential amino acids from some source of food. You know, it's just kind of the main thing to think with. It's the raw material for the body. So protein is not bad. And, I think that people thrive more, like if they have some source of animal protein, whether it's from bone broth or it's just like from the organs themselves or from bones, cartilage, etc. It's got this really interesting profile of amino acids that really helps to rebuild the body. But, you know, it just depends on what you're trying to do. If you're an athlete, depending on your age, you might consume more or less protein, and this is in terms of the quantities and when. These are things that we can get into in the future, but right now, just as a general overview, just think with protein as the raw material for the body, and you know you're going to need a variety of different, you know, types of proteins in order to actually get all of the amino acids that your body needs to rebuild itself, and make sure to get those essential amino acids as well. This is why, you know, one of our products is collagen, and the reason for that is because, like, if you just ate chicken breast all day long every day, you're not getting all of the, you know, the entire profile of amino acids that you need. And so it's much better to get the chicken skin or the bones, etc. People are just like in a hurry these days. So the collagen has a specific amino acid profile that contains some of the essential amino acids that are great to rebuild the hair, skin, and nails. And the digestive tract and the joints and things that people don't get just from, you know, animal meat, like a chicken breast or something like that, you know. So yeah, this is just something to think with overall when you're looking at different proteins. You're like, oh, this has protein, that has protein, this has protein. Great, get a variety of them, but also look out for those essential amino acids and see how you're going to get those into your diet, especially if you're vegetarian or vegan. You really have to be much more nitpicky about where you're getting these amino acids, because, you know, your body needs to be fully nourished with them in order to repair itself. So it's something that I think to some degree has sort of been demonized by some parties, protein, especially animal protein, but I think that it does serve a very good, important function for human health. And it's just important to know what the source of it is, you know, that those animals were treated correctly, hopefully from a sustainable source. You know, these are the best things. And it just depends on what you're doing and what your body looks like, whether you need a lot or a little bit, depending on your goals and just your general physique. All right, so thanks so much for tuning in. This is just a basic overview. Like I said, we'll go much more in depth regarding, you know, quantities and dosing depending on people's goals, etc. But right now, I just wanted to give you that overview. Hopefully that's helpful for you, and share this information with anyone you think could benefit. And I will see you on the flip side.